You're watching Island Post News Daily.
The Confederation of Meghalaya Social Organizations is holding a black flag protest on November 27 and a sit-in protest on December 4 in all the districts of the state against the non-implementation of inner line permit in the state. In a statement issued here today, the CoMSO stated that the resolution on the ILP passed by the Meghalaya Assembly on December 19, 2019 should have been honored by the Government of India. The delay in implementing the ILP in Meghalaya is not because the center is yet to study the resolution passed by the Assembly, but it is due to lack of political will. If people of other states have the right to protect themselves through ILP, why the indigenous people of Meghalaya are not being able to enjoy the same right? CoMSO Chairman Robert June Karjarinson.
Today we have a meeting at Meghu to thinking of the step forward in demanding implementation of ILP in the state of Meghalaya. If we see the history of ILP in India, it's not something new. It has been there since the British era, and even in India independent, this law has been implemented in 4 state economies. So to say that for the Union government that it will take almost a year to study implementation of ILP in the state of Meghalaya is something which we do not accept at all. It's not. The delay is not about studying the pros and cons of implementation of ILP, but it seems like the delay is about lack of political wills. It seems like the Union government under the leadership of BJP did not have the political will to implement inner line permit in the state of Meghalaya. So we ask a question to the Union government, if other indigenous people in other states like Manipur, Nagaland, Arunachal, and Mizoram have the right to protect themselves from being outnumbered in their own backyard and their own land. Why we, the Hinduja people and the Aceh people, do not have the same right? We are not second to none. We are not some second class citizen in India. We are also the indigenous people of the state of Meghalaya. And we have the same right as other have in terms of protection of our own demographic structures. So we demand the Union government to speed it up implementation of inner line permit in the state of Meghalaya, which we believe that this legislation will go a long way toward protection and preserve of the indigenous people, culture, land, demographic structures, and importantly, the uniqueness identity of our own people in the state of Meghalaya. This is nothing racist about it. There is nothing that we are against somebody else. This is purely a matter of protections to ourselves, since we are a minority in every front, be it linguistically, be it the numbers that we have, the religious that we have. We are minority in all fronts. So if we do not protect ourselves in just a matter of few years, we will be minority in our own state, in our own land. Accept our demand. We'll finally consider the opinion and the long-standing demand of the indigenous people of the state of Meghalaya. And we hope that with implementation of ILP in the state, we will see a lot of good things happening at the state of Meghalaya. So this is the first thing that we have demand, and we have also demanded the Meghalaya government should reintroduce the Meghalaya Safety Security Amendment Bill, which has been returned by the governor, because we believe that this legislation also will help in protection the indigenous people in the state of Meghalaya, just like ILP itself. So we are surprised to see that the governor, who is supposed to act under the advice of the Council of Ministers, dictate the government. So we confuse whether who is the real head, whether the chief ministers of the state is the real head or the governors the real head. So we hope that the state government will once again pass it in the assembly, and we hope that the honorable governor of the state of Meghalaya will have the confidence in the indigenous people of the state, and he will give his assent to this bill. And we have also decided that we will start our agitation on 27 November we will have a black flag in all the district headquarters of the state of Meghalaya. And also on the 4th of December, we will have the sit-in demonstration in all district headquarters of the state of Meghalaya. Since we are also concerned with all with this pandemic, and we want to observe all the protocol issued by the state government, we have declared that during the black flag, we will not allow our members, you know, to put black flag to people, because we don't want to have the contact between two people, but black flag will be put only in the cars and in public places. But there will no putting of black flag to individual. And on the food also, we will try to maintain the numbers of more than 50. Of course, if the district administration allow, we will try to ask for more than just 50. But nevertheless, as we see that COVID and pandemic also is a matter of life and death, ILP and others also is a matter of life and death, and we try to maintain a balance, strike a balance between the two, and we do hope that we as a people of the state, we have also decided that we will soon write a letter to the PMO, Prime Minister Office, and also to the Home Minister, and also to all the three MPs of Meghalaya, because as we know that the ILP now is in Central Court. So we would like to see that our three MPs from the state of Meghalaya should take this matter seriously, and we hope that the Honourable Prime Minister of India and the Honourable Home Minister of India also will appreciate the wish and the aspiration of the indigenous people of the state of Meghalaya by honouring the resolution unanimously passed by our Honourable MLA in the floors of the House on the 19 December 2019. So we hope that with this communication, the central government will take the matter a bit serious and will understand the aspiration and the wish of the indigenous people of the state of Meghalaya. We have met various ministers, and on each meeting that we met them, even if we go and talk and discuss other issues, we always ask what's happening to ILP, we always ask what's happening to the inclusion of Khasi language in the exceedual resolution, what's happening to MRSA. There was not even a single time that when we met the CM or the Deputy CM or the other ministers, or even when we met the MLA, there is not even a single moment that we neglect to ask this important issue. We always follow up this issue, but you know, the answer is always like that the central government is still studying, the central government is examining. And as we see that examining of this implementation of this law need not to be take time like this, because the government of India has already implemented in 4 states, and recently they implement in Manipur. So what is wrong of implementing in the state of Meghalaya? If they could have the same privilege, the same right to protect their land, their identity, their cultures, to protect themselves from being outnumbered in their own backyard, I think we also have the same thing. So we hope that our honorable ministers, the ministers and MLA of our state also will take this matter seriously. We do hope to see them that they should not agitate only in the assembly, but they should also agitate in the street along with the people of the state, so that we will show that yes, the indigenous people of the state of Meghalaya want ILP, and we want, it's not for other reason, but for wholly for to what the bona fide need of protection our own interests of and protection of our own identity.